नमस्ते फ्रेंड्स वन एंड ऑल, लेट मी टेक दिस सब्जेक्ट मच फर्दर. इन माय प्रीवियस वीडियो आई वाज टॉकिंग अबाउट द एम्प्लॉयबिलिटी एंड द एम्प्लॉयमेंट ऑपर्चुनिटीज क्रिएशन. नाउ लेट्स ट्राई एनालाइजिंग ईच एंड एवरी फील्ड्स वेयर इन the employability or the employment opportunities could be created. Now let's try analyzing these factors and cofactors. One is IT industry, which includes ITES sector as well. Other is art and culture. Other is hotel industry. Other is tourism industry, but subject to limitations in itself. When I say limitations, it has to have some kind of rules and regulations towards the thing, because this pandemic attack virus is going at a rapid pace, and so here tourism is again exceptional, wherein tourism does not mean going to places in a group or anything like that. From the recreational point of view and from the medicational point of view, from the therapeutic point of view, MSMEs, small scale industries under NREGS scheme providing the employability operations or the opportunities to the individuals, specifically in the rural sector as well as urban and semi-urban. However, rural sector, urban, semi-urban, all of these and metropolitan cities, in all of these the art and culture, hotel industry, tourism industry, MSMEs, small scale industries come as bits and pieces. Agricultural being the fields or the opportunities where you can cultivate your land, produce and give it to the people and get whatever that you want. This also could be one source of income. Coming to the point of IT sector, IT industry today is dependent on the projects from foreign land, that is foreign western countries, something major like US, Australia, Canada, UK, German, and you name it. Now if one could understand the brief gist of getting projects in local Indian countries itself, because the abundance of talent, the abundance of thought process, the natural thinking, the natural way of natural intelligence of the students is existing in India itself. Now for this, the factors and cofactors are the colleges, schools, institutions, research institutions. They need to provide that infrastructure. Now they need to be having certain set of standards at a highest level. Now for this there is other factor also. Leave the bureaucrats or the politicians who play, you know, who try to play with the system and the schemes. Till now what is happening is most of the schemes of the Indian projects, there is no standard level of payment done. It's like cheating everyone. On papers it is one thing, but when it comes to reality, they don't do anything, they don't give anything. And that is one reason why the IT major companies, if we really look at, they are concentrating on the Westerners or the foreign land. Now, out of these, in the IT, art and culture has become one of the primary things that every individual is doing. Now, to create that employment opportunity or employability of an individual, one can learn this fine arts and culture and create that environment. Now is the time where the gurus, teachers, or the individuals who are learning dance need to really put their efforts. Factors being, they need to think from the knowledge point of view. Note, it's a note and disclaimer. Let's not think from the profit motive point of view or whatever that knowledge that you are giving. It has to be genuine. Please understand this. This is very important point. What is the kind of knowledge that you are giving to the student whom you are teaching? This is a very important point which one needs to understand. It's high time. Let's break these barriers and let's break these lines. Now, in this pandemic attack situation or in this situation where there are no opportunities available, what is happening is we people are getting succumbed to the situation. And this is being encashed by the people who think they know everything and they act and they don't give that knowledge to the students or the people who are living on that solely for as a bread and butter. And that is one reason why dancers, teachers, below lower level, teachers and renowned scholars and purohits, priests and Vedic pandits, however they are surviving because they do have their own means, they are getting it. Now it's high time that everyone should come one along and try to understand what is the kind of help that we can do to, you know, empower the economic system, boost the economic system as a whole. This is very important, and this is where the art and culture industry plays the key role. They need to come up with an idea. Stop thinking from individualistic point of view. Start thinking from the universal point of view now. In case if you are not acting now, it is not possible for anyone to grow. You will be also doomed and damned. Everyone will get doomed. Already, number of artists who are suffering, they are in lakhs across India, across globe. Coming to the IT projects, it's high time politicians, bureaucrats, celebrities, stop thinking from your point of view. Stop that nonsense, nepotism, hypocritic thinking. Stop giving your giving your lecture. Start acting universally. Don't play hide and seek. Enough of this. We have done this for centuries, and we have done this for years. If you think that whatever that you are talking is making sense, I would say it is not making any sense. It has created a dent, and at this position, at today in this pandemic attack, if people are not able to recover, it is only due to your 2% of insane thought process of nepotism, hypocrisy, whatnot. Let's be fair enough on this. And coming to the IT industries. IT industries need to really think from the Indian's point of view. They need to think to get that get the employment opportunity, create that employment opportunity for the individual from the rural areas. There is enough of talent in the rural areas, urban areas, and semi-rural areas. Can we explore over that? I know that there are limitations. We have bureaucrats, we have politicians intervening, and they are spoiling the environment. Forget about that. And this is a strong message to bureaucrats and the individuals who are thinking for themselves. Sorry to be harsh and blunt, but enough of this game. Let's start thinking from the Indian point of view. Let's try mobilizing the employment and the employability opportunities in India itself. I know that we have major projects, and we are getting enough of income from the Western projects. You know why IT companies or the people who are investing their money in the software companies? Because they are they are having that reliability of getting the money back from the Westerners, because they have that genuinity. And today, why are we losing our interest in the Indian companies is that we people are thinking selfishly for our own self, our own growth factors. This is a very important point that has to be noted. I am extremely sorry to say this out of my census, out of my census report and the stats, what I have seen is most of the companies are going to abroad only for this reason. Even the PhD holders who are doing the research, they say, majority of them say that whatever infrastructure or whatever that we are not having, there we are finding. And this is where we are getting downtrodden. And I see all the nonsense that Modi ji speaks. Why is he not addressing this opportunity of IT companies or the projects from India to this day? Coming to the art and culture, how many of the teachers, how many of the gurus really think that whatever heritage and culture that we have from the Vedas and Upanishads has come from India and this is being used by Westerners? And we are getting used to Western countries. It's high time for the established dancers and established teachers to understand this and start mobilizing and nurturing that kind of opportunity, that kind of employment opportunity and employability in the society. How many of us really think about it? Is my question. Is there a way out that we could really work it out? I'm sorry, but this has been happening and is still happening in the pandemic attack situation. Why are we not thinking on those grounds? Let's be honest on that. Enough of this nepotism, enough of this misogynistic attitude, enough of this shrewd mentality. Let's grow up. Let's try working collectively towards the growth of the Indian economy system. Hotels. I agree. Let's start with small thing. Why are we thinking at a higher end? In this pandemic attack situation, let's follow the precautions and let's try working it out. Let's see what is it that could be done for the hotels to really look at it. Coming to the tourism industry. Tourism does not mean going to places and having that enjoyment and taking the clicks and all. It involves even the personality development as well, right? You go to a place, have that secluded kind of thing with all kinds of limitations, with some limitations, and try to quarantine yourself and see if India could find if we as individuals could find that, we can find that quarantine nature of that. Am I right? I may be sounding harsh and rude, but let's be realistic on this. Why are we stopping that kind of thing? Coming to the MSME and small scale industries. These MSMEs and small scale industries again. Why is government concentrating on the people who are already having business and they do not have what you call capital and all? I was seeing Modi ji's Rojgar Yojanas. It is only for them. Then what do these individuals, what do these individuals who are fresh out of graduate and who have lost their jobs? Is this what Modi ji is talking about? Employability and employment opportunities he is talking. Can we really look at it from that front? And on the other hand, I see that top people like Vijay Mallya and all are really like cooling themselves in abroad. Now my point is, the MSMEs or the small scale industries really need to concentrate on the rural, semi-rural, rural, urban, semi-urban, and the unemployment, the unemployed youth or unemployed individual who are suffering. And they are not trying to understand, try to help them with some kind of knowledge and give them some kind of, monetary push. Help them with some money so that they could at least put pawn shop. If there are 10 pawn shops, this is also one kind of industry. If there are 10 pawn shops, if you get 10 rupees out of it as a part of income tax, that is also an income. Like this, if I go with whole of the Indian continent. It will come into crores. And he was talking about, Modiji was talking about black money. Where did this black money go? And why is he not investing on all of this now? What is that hitch that he is having? Now, coming to the point of manufacturing concerns or the small scale industries. Now I was talking about pawn shops and other things. There are some people who are talented in fabric and other things. They can produce saris, they can produce khadi items. Are we really helping them out? Don't tell me that just we do not have enough money. Where has that income tax, whatever that you were charging from the top level executives, gone? Let's do away with the misogynistic and the nepotistic attitude. Start thinking about it. Coming to the IT industry, it's high time someone who is already established like Microsoft, Tech Mahindra, Infosys and other companies who are having enough of reserves, start thinking, concentrating in the Indian environment. Forget about Western countries and create that opportunities. Create that employment or the employability of it in the rural areas. If we are trying to do that implementation, it would be really helpful. And for the institutions, educational institutions, research institutions across all domains, be it fine arts and culture, be it craft work, be it vocational, be it anything, specifically for fine arts and culture, this is one major area and one of the cofactors that will really help the existing dancers or the teachers or the gurus to really sustain themselves. And now for the institutions, colleges and schools and research colleges, it's high time they need to start thinking from the front of knowledge point of view. What is the kind of knowledge he or she is holding? And start nurturing them. Start thinking. Maybe yes, I might sound rude and blunt, but I need to say this. Enough of this. We have had enough of this in art and culture. The kind of nepotism, the kind of misogynistic attitude, the kind of whatever that I say. I'm extremely sorry to say this. This I am telling out of my own experience by going to colleges. I had been to universities showing my works. Irrespective of whether it is good or bad, try to look at it at least. And create that space for him or her as an individual. Creating that employment or employability kind of thing. It's not out of frustration that I am talking. But these are the possible views, these are the possible factors and these are the possible ways that one can really look at creating that point. And we do not want to really look at it. This lockdown will continue. This lockdown environment will continue. Why are we not investing on that? Ladies and gentlemen, one and all, my only point is, please understand these pointers specifically for IT industry, art and culture, hotel, tourism, MSME, small scale industries, NREGS scheme, agricultural. Now, of these hotel, tourism, MSME, small scale industries, NREGS scheme, agricultural requires some sort of understanding, some sort of understanding and some sort of limitations. But when it comes to art and culture, this is one field that can really create employability and employment opportunities. It is time for the regrouping of the scholars, teachers, so-called gurus. They keep that name tag gurus, right? Everyone. However, exceptions are there. I am not being harsh to them, but exceptions are always there. This is only for the one who keeps that guru tag or the anything. They need to start thinking how best we can really look at. Stop showing, stop using nepotism, stop using misogynistic attitude, stop thinking from the personal growth point of view. Start recruiting. Think of what is it that we can do. For IT industries, think from the Indian perspective and try to tap into the urban, semi-urban, literates who are having that knowledge, how you can do that. These being the pointers, I conclude this video with a positive note. Stay blessed. Have a blissful life. May the Guru's grace be with all. Have a nice day.